Congratulations on your new marriage.
Thank you, very lucky woman right there.
Yes, she is. I was wondering, since you're kind of controversial sometimes,
I don't think so,
but what's the best way to handle so much fame?
Oh, wow.
As an aspiring comedian?
Oh, really? As you are the aspiring comedian?
Yes, but you know, I see how you get mobbed, and I'm like, how does he handle it?
Oh, I appreciate that, but I mean, that's a wonderful thing. You know, the fans choose that. The fans choose whether they want to be around a person or not. And if you're fortunate enough to be in that spot, you know, you take your time. I take my cues from the top. Dana White is the guy that gives more time and more attention to people, random people and fans and strangers on the street than anybody. And I try to do the same thing.
Long live Chael Sonnen.
Long live Chael Sonnen. Thank you, buddy. And long live you.
Hey, Chael. My name's Justin. I thought when you were going through the Ultimate Fighter, you talked to, like, especially when you were talking to Uriah Hall, and you were in the room and he was envisioning the fights, and you said, you know, think about, you're going to get hit, you know, you might get rocked. And specifically when you were talking before the John Jones fight, you said, I'm not sure, I might not win. Do you think that's a mentality that helps you, or even that, do you see it with other fighters? Because I see a lot of, like, the pre-fight interviews, and they're just, I'm going to win this fight, I'm going to knock him out, there's no way I'm going down. Do you think that helps you?
Well, I tell you, I really think you need to envision what could possibly happen out there. You know, and people tell you, I never doubted myself. Well, that's just ridiculous. Of course you did. But that's okay. You got to make that walk anyway. And sometimes you're going in there thinking, man, this guy's got better skills than me. And if you're a bully, you'll stay in the back. And if you're a gangster, you'll make that walk anyway.
Cutting weight, is it better to fight guys that are smaller, but you exhausted yourself in cutting weight, or is it better just to fight the bigger guy at the higher weight class?
Definitely better to fight a bigger guy. The whole term, weight advantage, that just means who weighs more. From time guys were little kids on the playground, that's who we decided who was toughest, right? Whoever was the biggest. And then if you got beat up, it was easier to tell your mom and dad, yeah, but he was bigger than me. Look, Muhammad Ali was 198 pounds. Mike Tyson in his prime was 220 pounds. Cain Velasquez is the most undersized heavyweight in the entire UFC. You always want to be the smaller guy. You always want to be a little bit faster in the fight game.
Okay. All right. Thank you, sir.
Cool.
Thank you. Yes, sir.
Hey, Chael. Big fan. Not a later.
You have very good taste.
I also have your commentary, and I was kind of wondering, I've heard it insinuated a few times from Dana White that Fox is really in love with you as far as, like, your commentary goes, and that they may have bigger plans for you. So, outside of just the stuff that you're doing with UFC and Fox Sports 1, I'm assuming, is there any other realm that you're working with Fox, maybe in the future, with any other sports you'd want to maybe do commentary for?
You know, I'm not against it. First and foremost, I'm an athlete. I want to compete and compete with as many guys as I can for as long as I can, as long as I can keep working hard and keep enjoying the sport. But, you know, I love talking about it too. I love times like this. I could sit and talk with you all day about it. If somebody wants to put it on camera and hand me a check at the end of the night, I'm not going to not take it. But I don't feel like that's a job. I've never felt like that was going to work and it was just a good time. I get to sit with fine gentlemen like my good friend John here, talk sports all day, and they call it a job. I don't know how.
Thank you.
Pleasure.
Thank you.
Pleasure.
Yes, sir.
Hi. I have two questions.
Shoot.
Who are, like, fighters that you just don't like?
That I do not like?
Yeah.
Oh, geez. I don't know, man. It'd be tough. I fought most of them, you know. And after you fight a guy, there's generally a camaraderie that forms there. You know, whether you like him or not, there's an appreciation of the event and of the sportsmanship that comes from it. I probably could have named five guys.
Yeah. And I think you should run for president.
That's a very good vote. It's a very good vote. When you get to the legal age, write me in. All right.
Yes, dear.
Hi, Chael.
true.
Hello, beautiful.
Thank you. I was wondering, when you fought Anderson Silva the first time, you did beat him up really good at the beginning, but when he got you in an armbar, how did you feel?
You know what? It was a choke. It was a triangle choke, and it felt very, very tight. He had old Chael on that one. You know, sometimes you're beat. You gotta just acknowledge it. It's part of sports.
On the second fight, when you fought him, when you do a ring, like when you fight him again, do you feel like stronger or do you feel weaker?
You know, not for nothing, and he wins a lot of fights, man. I'll give him his due. He's had an amazing career, but that is the luckiest son of a bitch I have ever met. I come out, I whip this guy for 30 minutes. He gets to jump on me for 30 seconds, and they call him the winner? He didn't knock me down. I fell down. They call that fight a knockout? I couldn't have been more awake. That whole thing was fugazi. But again, if you're going to compete, you shut your mouth and you walk out and live with the result, and that's what I did.
I'd just like to get your ass kicked by Kevin James.
You know what? He's a pretty good guy. As a matter of fact, Kevin James, the King of Queens, if that name doesn't ring a bell. He's a big fan. He loves the sport. He practices in the sport. He's a Catholic. I'm a Catholic. He's a Republican. I'm a Republican. We got a lot of stuff in common. It was a pleasure.
Can I get a picture with you later?
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Hey, Joe. As an aspiring wrestler, I was coming here to state my senior year. I was just wondering your thoughts about the Olympics in wrestling.
Well, I mean, this is a big blow. Wrestling is one of the few sports that is truly global. Global. Now, I gave basketball a hard time earlier, but that's a great sport. Everybody plays it. You get a hoop. It's a good sport. My uncle won 2 NBA championships. So I admire those sports, but it's not global. It's very unique to this country. Wrestling is in every single country in the world, and if you remove that from the games, you remove Iran from the movement. You're not going to find an Iranian that wins a medal that isn't in wrestling. You're going to remove Russia in large part from the movement. You're going to take Cuba out of the Olympic Games. It's a very, very big deal globally, and I really hope it doesn't happen.
Yeah, me too. Can I get a picture of this, too?
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Hey, Chael, first off, I want to say mad props for win, lose, or draw. You always bring your best.
Thank you.
Number two, I want to brought my friend Shelly here, who 7 weeks ago had a brain tumor removed. And one of the things that we wanted to see was be able to make sure we got a picture with you. And mad respect for being a fan. So
I would love to do it. Shelly, let's do it right now, just in case something happens. And congratulations on making it through that battle.
Chael Sonnen, EsNewsReport.com, amongst the very important.